Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Mystery of Queen Nefertiti's Gold. Chapter 1. The Lost Gold of Nefertiti. Detective John Avery, a seasoned investigator with a penchant for historical mysteries, found himself in the land of the pharaohs, under the scorching sun of Egypt. His latest case was a pursuit shrouded in antiquity, the search for the lost gold of Queen Nefertiti. The fabled treasure of the queen, one of the most enigmatic figures of ancient Egypt, had long been a subject of legend, and Avery was determined to unravel its secrets. His journey began in the Valley of the Kings, the ancient burial ground of Egypt's pharaohs and nobility. As Avery walked among the tomb-laden hills, the whispers of millennia past seemed to echo around him. The detective was well aware that he was treading on sacred ground, a place where history and myth intertwined. Avery's first step was to explore the royal tombs. He knew that understanding Nefertiti's time and her connection to the pharaoh Akhenaten was crucial. Nefertiti was more than just a queen, she was a central figure in a religious upheaval that saw the traditional pantheon of gods replaced with the worship of a single deity, the Aten, or Sun Disk. As Avery descended into the tombs, he felt a chill that seemed at odds with the desert heat. The hieroglyphs on the tomb walls told stories of power, reverence, and the afterlife, a narrative that Avery knew could hold clues to the location and purpose of Nefertiti's gold. In his quest for answers, Avery met with archaeologists and Egyptologists who provided him with invaluable insights into the period's religious and political dynamics. He learned of the Amarna period, a time of significant change when Akhenaten relocated the capital to Amarna and focused on the monotheistic worship of the Aten. Nefertiti was central to this shift, often depicted in a position of power equal to the pharaoh himself. Avery's exploration took a significant turn when he encountered an elderly local guide who shared a legend passed down through generations. The legend spoke of Nefertiti's hidden chamber, a room filled with gold and artifacts that served a purpose beyond mere wealth. Intrigued, Avery delved deeper into the local lore, seeking out stories and clues that might lead him to this chamber. The guide led Avery to an unassuming location near the cliffs overlooking the Nile. Hidden away from the main tourist paths, they found a series of lesser-known tombs, untouched by most archaeologists. Here, Avery discovered symbols and references that were not recorded in any official records, symbols that hinted at a secret chamber connected to Nefertiti. Avery's nights were spent poring over texts and maps, piecing together the puzzle of the Queen's gold. He learned of ancient religious practices that involved gold and rituals designed to harness the power of the sun and secure a prosperous afterlife. The gold, Avery hypothesized, was not merely treasure but a key component in these lost rituals. As Avery's investigation deepened, he found himself entangled in a web of intrigue that extended beyond the ancient past. He learned of rival treasure hunters and black market antiquities dealers, all drawn by the allure of Nefertiti's gold. Avery knew he had to tread carefully, as these players would stop at nothing to claim the treasure for themselves. Determined to find the truth, Avery planned an expedition to a site he had identified as a potential location of the hidden chamber. Equipped with the latest in archaeological tools and a team of trusted experts, he set out to uncover a mystery that had remained hidden for over 3,000 years. As Avery and his team worked, they uncovered a hidden entrance beneath the sands, an entrance that seemed to lead to the heart of the mystery. The passage was narrow and treacherous, winding deep into the heart of the cliffs. Finally, they emerged into a chamber that took their breath away. The walls were adorned with intricate paintings of Nefertiti and Akhenaten, basking in the rays of the Aten. Amidst these stunning depictions, they found artifacts and, to their astonishment, the glimmer of gold. The discovery was just the beginning. Avery knew that the true mystery of Nefertiti's gold lay not just in its material value, but in its connection to the ancient world's spiritual and occult powers. As he stood in the chamber, surrounded by the echoes of a forgotten age, he realized that he was on the brink of unraveling one of history's greatest enigmas. Chapter 2. Unearthing Ancient Secrets. In the ancient city of Amarna, once the capital established by Pharaoh Akhenaten and Queen Nefertiti, Detective John Avery delved deeper into the mystery of the lost gold. The city, now in ruins, whispered secrets of a past when it stood at the center of a religious revolution. Avery's investigation here was crucial. He believed that understanding the life and times of Nefertiti was key to unlocking the mystery of her gold. As Avery explored the remnants of Amarna, he was struck by the art and architecture that marked Akhenaten's reign. The pharaoh and his queen were depicted in a style that broke from traditional Egyptian norms, emphasizing their unique religious devotion to the Aten. Avery hypothesized that the gold, rumored to be Nefertiti's, could be intricately linked to this period of religious upheaval. His first significant discovery came when he uncovered a hidden chamber within the great temple of the Aten. The chamber, long forgotten and buried under centuries of sand and debris, contained relics and inscriptions that shed light on the role of gold in the royal couple's religious practices. The walls of the chamber were lined with faded reliefs depicting Nefertiti and Akhenaten in various ceremonial garbs, adorned with gold that shone with the sun's rays. These images suggested that the gold was more than a symbol of wealth. It was a sacred element in their worship of the Aten, used in rituals to invoke the deity's favor and power. Avery's study of the chamber led him to a series of ancient papyri hidden within a sealed pottery jar. The papyri were fragile but legible, containing hymns and prayers dedicated to the Aten, many referencing the use of gold in religious ceremonies. These texts offered Avery a glimpse into the spiritual significance of the gold in Amarna's society and its potential connection to the divine. As Avery pieced together the evidence, he realized that the gold's disappearance might have coincided with the fall of Amarna. After Akhenaten's death, there was a return to traditional Egyptian polytheism, and Amarna was abandoned. Avery theorized that the gold could have been hidden or moved during this turbulent period, perhaps to protect it from those who would see it melted down or repurposed. Avery's investigation took him to the outskirts of Amarna, where recent archaeological excavations had unearthed a series of tombs belonging to high priests and nobles of Akhenaten's court. It was here that he found the next clue, a tomb that had been sealed off, untouched since its creation. Inside the tomb, Avery found references to a secret sect that had remained loyal to Akhenaten and Nefertiti's religious reforms even after their deaths. The sect, according to inscriptions, was tasked with protecting the sacred gold, believed to be imbued with the essence of the Aten. This revelation pointed Avery towards a new line of inquiry, the possibility that the gold was hidden not just for safekeeping but as part of a continuing religious tradition. The deeper Avery delved into the history of Amarna and the reign of Akhenaten and Nefertiti, the more he realized that the mystery of the gold was tied to ancient religious and political intrigue. It was a treasure that carried with it the weight of a lost era, a symbol of a pharaoh and queen's attempt to redefine the spiritual landscape of ancient Egypt. However, Avery's investigation was not without its dangers. The allure of Nefertiti's gold had attracted other, less scrupulous treasure hunters. He found himself in a race against time and adversaries who cared little for the historical significance of the gold and only for its material value. Determined to find the gold and protect its historical integrity, Avery planned a daring venture into the deeper reaches of the Amarna ruins. Equipped with the knowledge he had gathered and the help of trusted local experts, Avery set out to uncover a treasure that had remained hidden for over 3,000 years. As he ventured into the unexplored chambers and passageways of Amarna, Avery felt as though he were walking through history, each step bringing him closer to solving one of ancient Egypt's greatest mysteries. The shadows of the past seemed to cling to the ruins, and Avery knew that the secrets they held were about to be brought to light. Chapter 3. The Curse of the Pharaohs. Detective John Avery's search for Queen Nefertiti's lost gold had led him deep into the heart of ancient Egyptian mysteries. His journey through the ruins of Amarna and the Valley of the Kings had uncovered tantalizing clues, but it was the discovery of a hidden chamber beneath the Temple of Aten that marked a pivotal moment in his investigation. The chamber, sealed for millennia, was a repository of ancient knowledge and artifacts. Among these was a series of scrolls that detailed not only the religious practices of Akhenaten and Nefertiti but also spoke of a curse that guarded the queen's gold. The curse, as described in the scrolls, was a protective measure invoked to safeguard the sacred treasure from those who would misuse its power. Avery, a skeptic by nature, initially dismissed the idea of a curse as superstitious folklore. However, as he delved deeper into the mystery, strange occurrences began to surround his expedition. His team experienced a series of inexplicable equipment failures and unsettling incidents that could not be easily explained. Local guides spoke in hushed tones of the wrath of the ancient gods, warning Avery that he was treading on forbidden ground. Undeterred by these challenges, Avery continued his quest, driven by a growing fascination with the ancient world's secrets. His investigation led him to the heart of Amarna, where he discovered a wall painting in a forgotten tomb. The painting depicted a ritual involving Nefertiti's gold, suggesting that the treasure was more than mere wealth. It was a key element in ceremonies believed to harness celestial powers. As Avery pieced together the puzzle, he realized that the curse was tied to these ancient rituals. It was an ancient safeguard against the disruption of the cosmic balance, a balance maintained through the rituals conducted by Akhenaten and Nefertiti. The theft or misuse of the gold could potentially unleash chaos, an outcome the ancients had sought to prevent at all costs. The detective's journey took a perilous turn when he began to experience vivid dreams, visions of ancient Egypt that were both enlightening and foreboding. These dreams seemed to be a direct consequence of his proximity to the gold and his interference with the long-dormant energies it harbored. In one such dream, Avery found himself in the presence of Nefertiti, who spoke of the responsibilities that came with the knowledge of the gold. She warned of the dangers of awakening powers that mortals were not meant to wield, a message that resonated with Avery upon waking. Driven by a sense of duty to protect the world from the potential consequences of disturbing the gold, Avery redoubled his efforts to locate it. His search led him to a network of underground tunnels beneath Amarna, a labyrinth that had once connected the city's key religious and administrative buildings. Navigating these tunnels, Avery and his team uncovered a series of hidden chambers, each revealing more about the religious practices of the Amarna period. It was in the deepest of these chambers that Avery finally found what he had been searching for, the gold of Queen Nefertiti. The treasure was as breathtaking as it was enigmatic, a collection of intricately crafted jewelry, ceremonial items, and gold coins, all bearing the symbols of the Eden. The craftsmanship was extraordinary, each piece a testament to the skill and artistry of ancient Egyptian goldsmiths. However, the discovery was overshadowed by a palpable sense of danger. Avery could feel the weight of the curse as he stood in the chamber, a feeling that was confirmed when another series of unexplained incidents struck his team. It became clear that the curse was more than just a legend, it was a real and present danger. Faced with the reality of the curse, Avery was forced to make a difficult decision. He realized that the gold was not meant to be disturbed, that its removal from its resting place could have dire consequences. In a bold move, he chose to leave the gold where it was, respecting its historical and spiritual significance. To ensure the safety of the site and the sanctity of the gold, Avery worked with local authorities and international organizations to secure the chamber. The gold of Queen Nefertiti was to remain a hidden treasure, protected not only by the physical barriers erected but also by the respect for its historical and mystical power. In the end, Avery's journey was not about the acquisition of treasure but about understanding and respecting the ancient world's mysteries. He had uncovered one of history's greatest secrets, but in doing so, he had also learned the importance of preserving the past and its lessons. As he left the ruins of Amarna, Avery knew that his adventure would be a tale for the ages. He had delved into the heart of an ancient mystery, coming face to face with powers that defied understanding. The curse of Nefertiti's gold would remain a legend, but for Avery, it was a poignant reminder of the enduring legacy of the ancient world and the mysteries that it still held. Chapter 4. Illuminating the Darkness. Detective John Avery stood in the depths of the ancient chamber beneath Amarna, the lost gold of Queen Nefertiti glimmering before him. He had unraveled one of the greatest mysteries of ancient Egypt, but with this discovery came a heavy responsibility. The curse associated with the gold, once a distant legend, was now a palpable presence in the dimly lit chamber. Avery's mind was a whirlwind of thoughts and emotions as he contemplated his next move. The gold, resplendent and enigmatic, was more than a treasure. It was a key to ancient knowledge, a link to the spiritual practices of a bygone era. Yet, the curse that protected it was a stark reminder of the dangers that came with disturbing the past. As he pondered the situation, Avery recalled the vivid dreams and warnings he had experienced. They were not mere figments of imagination, but messages from the ancients, urging caution and respect. He realized that taking the gold from its resting place could unleash consequences far beyond his understanding. Determined to make the right decision, Avery decided to document the discovery without disturbing the treasure. He meticulously photographed the chamber, the artifacts, and the gold, ensuring that every detail was captured for posterity. These images, he knew, would be invaluable to historians and archaeologists, offering insights into Nefertiti's reign and the religious practices of the Amarna period. With the documentation complete, Avery faced the task of securing the chamber. He collaborated with Egyptian authorities and international experts to develop a plan that would protect the site from looters and preserve its historical integrity. The chamber was sealed with state-of-the-art technology, its location kept confidential to prevent unauthorized access. In the weeks that followed, Avery worked tirelessly to compile his findings into a comprehensive report. He presented his research to the academic community, revealing the truth behind the legend of Nefertiti's gold. The report was a sensation, shedding light on a period of Egyptian history that had long been shrouded in mystery. Avery's revelation of the curse and his decision to leave the gold undisturbed were met with both admiration and controversy. Some argued that the treasure should have been retrieved for study and public display, but many agreed with Avery's respectful approach. The curse, whether real or symbolic, was a reminder of the need to approach the past with humility and caution. As news of the discovery spread, Avery became something of a legend himself. He had faced the unknown, confronted ancient powers, and emerged with a newfound respect for the mysteries of history. His adventure in the land of the pharaohs had been more than just an investigation. It had been a journey into the heart of ancient wisdom and a testament to the enduring allure of Egypt's past. In the end, the mystery of Queen Nefertiti's gold remained a tale of intrigue and wonder. The treasure lay hidden, a secret kept safe by time and the vigilant guardianship of those who understood its true value. Detective John Avery left Egypt with a sense of accomplishment and a deepened appreciation for the complexities of history. He had illuminated the darkness surrounding one of ancient Egypt's greatest enigmas, but in doing so, he had also learned that some mysteries were best left undisturbed, their secrets preserved for future generations to ponder and respect. As Avery boarded his flight home, he looked back at the desert landscape, feeling a connection to the ancient land that would stay with him forever. The case of Queen Nefertiti's gold was closed, but the lessons it taught him about the past, respect, and the pursuit of knowledge would continue to guide his path as a detective and as a seeker of truths hidden in the sands of time.